the conditions where the geode could form. There are a few others in the area, however, they're much smaller and they don't have the large celestite deposit like we do. Now, we came across the geode in 1897. Some of the workmen from the winery were out to look for a clean drinking source because they had been using the lake and it was making people sick. Surprise. Now, when the workmen broke into the cavern, they thought they had hit the jackpot. Unfortunately, though, for them, the dollar value of the celestite is almost nothing because it's too soft to be cut and polished for jewelry, for example. If you do try, the celestite just crushes to a fine powder. However, there was a time period where they did come into the geode and harvest the celestite for that powder because it does burn a bright red, and they would use it to make distress flares and fireworks. Now, before I came down, we always ask that no one touches the crystal, reason being the crystal in the geode isn't actively forming or growing. This is all that we have. So any damage to it is irreversible. You'll see this piece here next to me has some black on the face of it. That's actually oxidation from fingertip oils from touching over time. Now, one of our largest pieces in celestite in the cave is here. This is about 18 by 20 inches in diameter, but this piece of celestite would weigh over 200 pounds if I were to pull it out. There's also an area of crystal behind me that's missing that was actually donated to the Smithsonian and is on display in Washington, D.C. Now, each piece of the crystal seems to look different, but they're actually almost identical. Each piece of the celestite has 14 facets that meet at roughly 104-degree angles, though some have been damaged over time. We also actually took us about 10 years to make this passable for tours. They just went ahead and elongated on the path that was here from the time period when they harvested the celestite and then made it passable to make the little circle that we walk in. Income from cave tours is how we kept our doors open during Prohibition. 18 other wineries on the island closed. We sold our grape juice. We gave our tours. We looked the other way if someone was doing something else with that grape juice at that time. Do you guys have any questions for me? If not, you guys can go out this way by my duck sign. Just watch your head, or you can go back the way you came.